Hey everybody, this is Danielle. Daniel, great to be with you here, just setting up for our Brain Talk Tuesday. If you're new with me, please say hello. Say hello anyways, I'm dropping my stuff. As I would love to see where you're joining me from, but if you're new, let me know that you're new. I'd love to see who's joining me. Sorry, I'm getting a little late started. I had cats trying to knock down all my stuff. So if you're joining me, I am a holistic psychotherapist. I'm a licensed clinical social worker, doctor of clinical psychology student. It's a mouthful, but just know me by Danielle Daniel, holistic psych. And every single Tuesday, I love to bring different brain topics. This is my passion, is holistic treatment, what we can do to improve brain health just holistically. And that's lots of different approaches. So today I'm going to be talking about hypnotherapy, and whether it's a phenomenon or poppycock. I just think that's a fun word. And I know I did a research paper on this for my last research class, which was on in my doctorate in hypnotherapy. And I actually received quite a few hypnotherapy sessions. And I told everybody I'd be doing a video on it, and I hadn't yet. So I realized today that is what I'm going to do, talking about the brain and beliefs and really how you can accomplish anything when you can tap into the right neural pathways. And that's what hypnotherapy does. So as you're joining, whether you're watching live or recorded on YouTube, Facebook, love that you're saying hello and good to see you guys. And then tell me, what do you know or what are your thoughts? Hypnotherapy, phenomenon or poppycock? And if you've ever had hypnotherapy, if you've ever done anything with it, I would love to hear. All right, hey you guys, hey Julie, hey Frank, good to see you guys on. So I'm gonna dive right in. I want to let you know though, I am working on a database for emotional wellness that you guys, everybody, can contribute to, and it's going to be available probably in just a couple weeks. I'm so excited. So look for that, where you will be able to go in and share your experiences with using, you know, any type of holistic management for anxiety or maybe mood, all those types of things. We're going to share and just have a forum, a collaborative forum that people can learn from each other. So really excited to release that in the next few weeks, as well as a CEU course for psychopharmacology. So that's for counselors that will be able to receive CEUs by learning the science behind how aromatics influence the brain. So that is coming also by September. I think September 1st we're going to release that. So I will post and of course let you know about that. So great to see you guys chiming in here. Love my chat with you guys. So if anybody wants to be my scribe, my commenter, please do so. It's really great to see and hear, because I talk about a lot of brain science, which isn't always the easiest thing for our brain to conceptualize as I'm speaking fast. So Julie says she's done hypnotherapy twice. It worked great. Yeah, I would love to hear your experiences. Please type them in. So prior to my doctorate course, I had never done or seen hypnotherapy. And honestly, even though as a therapist, I kind of thought it was one of those things like, I don't know, poppycock maybe, or just, I just didn't see how it could be that valuable, because not a lot of therapists were doing it. So I figured it must not be that valuable. And my interest, you know, I became interested in it January. Yeah, it was January this year. And I thought, I'm going to go get some hypnotherapy sessions. And then I also was registering for a new course, and I'm in my electives in my doctorate. So I thought, oh, well, I'll take hypnotherapy. Oh my gosh. Blew my mind what it can do, because I got it done personally as well as did the research on it, which for me, like, the science is, it helps even more with my, you know, brain and processing of things. So really cool. So let's dive in. First of all, you know, hypnotherapy from just like Hollywood and other things, we get this, like, it gets a bad rap that maybe you get in a trance and you're going to end up doing things that you wouldn't do. And it's actually not true. You're not in a trance. You're not in such a suggestible state that you would do something you wouldn't do. And that's where we get a lot of our misconceptions, is of course movies, which has a lot of misconceptions there. But it's hypnotherapy. I'm going to go through my notes here from my research paper. You have hypno babies. I see that. That's awesome. Yes, for labor. Really good. So it's tied to various neurobiological processes in the brain. So what that means is that there's different pathways, right, in our brain. So I'm going to talk a lot about brain waves today and brain structure. So the very front of our brain is called the frontal lobe, right? Brilliant name, frontal lobe. But what it does is executive functioning. It's where, like, and beta brainwave mode. That's what most of us are in right now, in beta brainwave mode, where you're thinking and accessing and processing. Your frontal lobe is what causes your, like, impulse control, inhibitions, organization, everything to do with just structuring and thinking about things during the day, okay? We have emotion centers of our brain as well. We've got a memory center. We've got pleasure centers of the brain. And then we have subconscious. So I think it's 98. I want to say 98% of the processes, it's either 90 or 98, are subconscious that happens in our brain. And then only the 2 or 10, I'm forgetting my number, but 2 or 10%, that is actually conscious thought. So some of your subconscious thoughts are breathing, right? You just know to breathe. So you don't have to think, oh, I forgot to breathe last second, you know? So it's an easy thing you don't have to think about. Our heart, a lot of our functions, of course, our body functions and emotions and memory or belief systems are very much tied to your subconscious part of your brain. So we're gonna talk about how you access that. So normal, like I was saying, everyday thinking is beta brainwave mode. And what happens when we're in beta brainwave mode, or thanks Maria, you're the best. You always type stuff in. I really appreciate it. So when we're in beta brainwave mode, or using a lot of, my computer or my screen went blank for a second. When we are functioning in that mode, what happens is we have filters. So we have this, all of us in different cultures and different families, whatever, we have so many different filters that we're born like hearing and believing, and we create these belief systems. They're beliefs about our world. A lot of it stems from as a child, if you cry and you get, you know, held, it creates this belief that my verbalization will, you know, get me satisfaction in some realm, whether that be eating or sleeping or changing your diaper, right? And so babies who end up verbalizing and don't get that create a belief that there is no relief, there's no care for them, there's no safety, there's no nothing. I'm powerless to be able to get the need, my needs taken care of. So we create these filters. And when we're in conscious mode, like beta, and when we think about things and we're like, okay, I want to change this belief about myself, whether this could be weight, this could be confidence, this could be self-love or worthy to feel love, this could be anything to do with anything to do with the what I'm trying to say, the subconscious, right? So anything to do pain management, mental health, addictions, things like that, we have these beliefs that we create. So with tapping into the subconscious, we can actually change those. So we have these filters, okay? And when I think of something like I want to like have more confidence, I can think it, but then I have a filter system that may block that from actually happening for me. So that's where, you know, your filter system and brainwave modes are super important. So let's talk about, you know, hypnotherapy and how it taps into deeper, you know, brainwave modes. So hypnotherapy allows for a deeper focus in yourself and strength and processing. It's been used to control a lot of emotional and mental and physical wellness. Research has been done actually on pain, on hypnotherapy for the immune system, obviously labor, headaches, because what it does is when you're able to without that filter blocking what you're trying to do, right? Without that filter, you're able to subconsciously tell your body to produce its own endogenous pharmacology. So endogenous means internal neurochemicals that can help with pain or change emotions or change beliefs. And that's why, you know, using this beta brainwave mode is super important. And I'm going to show you how you can do this from home. I mean, going to hypnotherapists, that's a really good hypnotherapist, is really important as well. But this, I'm going to show you some stuff you can start doing actually today. So what the desirable brainwave mode, in order to bypass our belief filters that were created from childhood, from society, you know, whatever they may be, is called theta brainwave mode, okay? How many of you guys do yoga? So in yoga, in the very end, they have you lay down in shavasana, it's called. That actually taps into, if you can, you know, if you relax to that state, you can relax into theta brainwave mode, where you're not like fast asleep and dreaming and maybe snoring. It's just where your theta brainwave is between waking and consciousness. So it's between sleep and consciousness. And it's still, you're not filtering like you do at a conscious level. Yeah. Okay, so let me see. So slower brain, this is what my research showed me. Slower brain oscillations, which are electrical activity and neuronal frequencies, they help in a couple things, which is why hypnotherapy is really cool. Helps in memory recall, and it influences the emotional limbic circuits in the brain. So a couple ways, well, let me go into this first. So theta makes your front, theta brainwave mode, right? Puts your frontal lobe at like the back, has your frontal lobe take a back seat basically. So you, where you're like thinking, I don't know if that's really true. I don't know. They say, you know, like I remember, so growing up, I had definitely, you know, low self-esteem, and I knew like logically, like I was worthy to be loved. Like I could say like, I know like I'm no God logically, of course he loves me, but I didn't know it. I couldn't, it's like I blocked being able to feel it. And so it really took me some work to, you know, let go of what was blocking those filters, which are those belief systems that were blocking me from believing it, and not just kind of, well, yeah, logically, you know, God loves all his children. I just remember that was a big one for me, and having to really do the inner work through hypnotherapy to know it. And it's really a core piece of the confidence and self-love that we create, is having this relationship with the creator, with the universe, of knowing you're taken care of, which is like we are as a child, those needs that we need have taken care of. And if they weren't taken care of as a child, they're still a, what am I trying to say? An higher being that can take care of those. So anything is rewritable in your brain. So that's what I want to go into. So hypnotherapy has been researched to help with depression, PTSD, addictions, and even chronic pain and migraines. Like I said, they have done research on this. So it's actually been helpful. So, and I can see why with things that are so complex, like PTSD and addictions, for example, why hypnotherapy would probably be your best route that you can take. And so let me go into, during hypnosis, so what they do is when you go into a hypnotherapist, you know, usually you chat for a minute with the person, and then as you're sitting there with them, they have you close your eyes and they have you like get into a relaxed state. They kind of talk you into a very relaxed state where just your entire brain like calms down, you have deeper breathing, and you get, you know, basically relaxed but not asleep. So that's called theta brainwave mode, that shavasana type mode. And from there, if you have a good, you know, hypnotherapist, they'll walk you through different memories. Some memories that can come up that maybe you hadn't remembered, whether good or bad, that you can rewrite or anchor for yourself. They also help you visualize scenes to strengthen your neural pathways and belief systems. And through, you know, through that, so let me back up a second. One of the things that is really important to know is when you have a thinking and a belief pattern, it actually creates really, when you think something frequently and a lot and you have a belief, it creates a really strong network, a strong neurochemical pathway as well as like neurotransmitters and emotions. It creates receptors. I've talked about this before. So what happens is when you have this strong belief, let's just say that belief is like, internally, I'm not enough. Like, that's your belief. It's so strong that anybody trying to tell you, you are enough, just gets blocked and bounces off. Okay? So with hypnotherapy, what happens is it does take some time because these have to atrophy. Atrophy means they just stop getting used, so they start to shrivel and die. And you have to rebuild new ones, new neural pathways, and neurochemistry and emotions, right? That create such strong beliefs that if someone said to you, like, you're not doing enough, you could go, what? Shut up. You wouldn't even like buy into it. Where before, if someone else had said that, you're not doing enough, you might go, oh my gosh, I'm not. They don't think, I mean, you would just, it would just absorb right in because it would fit right into your strengthened neural pathway. Does that make sense? I want to try to explain this the best I can for the brain. So let me know if this is like really sinking in for you, good for you guys. So these neural pathways, right? So when you go to hypnotherapy, it's able to bypass these because you're in a relaxed state, and it helps you start to create new ones that can become strong and helps the other ones atrophy. And then that creates new emotions and new beliefs. I remember in high school, of course, I told you guys I didn't have like the highest self-esteem, and I had this boyfriend. I was totally like head over heels, varsity football player, like, you know, amazing. He was in the news all the time, but he wasn't very good to me, but I just allowed it. And now I look back, I'm like, oh my gosh, I would never allow a guy to treat me like that. But you know, he would just get moody and say rude things. And I'd be like, okay, you know, now I'm like, oh my gosh. So that's what that's the example I want to give you. When you have strong neural pathways and someone says something, whether it be positive or negative, it's going to go right into that neural pathway. So let's build positive ones. And that's what hypnotherapy can do. It can help you bypass those so you can start to strengthen new ones. Okay, so I see some comments coming up about, you know, I saw the ones with nightmares or depression or migraines. Yeah, I'm going to show you what you can do to release those negative things in your life through hypnotherapy. It's really phenomenal. Okay, let me look at my notes so I'm not skipping too much. Okay, so one of the things you can start to do is, so lavender and Siberian fir oil, sorry, I feel like I'm forget my notes here. They have been researched actually to promote relaxation, but also to that they've been researched to increase theta brainwave activity. Now there's probably a lot of other essential oils, aromas, plants that do that, but these two specifically, so it's lavender and Siberian fir, and so that is what I call theta brain blend. And what I do, so you guys can do this at home, in this little, this is a 5 milliliter bottle, I put about 15 drops of lavender, 15 to 20 of lavender, 15 to 20 of Siberian fir. Okay. So every night when I'm going to sleep, I'm going to show you another thing, but what I do is I put them on, I don't want to put it on now. I don't need to go in theta brainwave mode right now, but put it on right here, pulse points on the neck and the back of the neck. Just do a little swipe. And then it smells really good. The rest of it, you're going to fill with fractionated coconut oil, some type of carrier oil. Okay, so it could be almond oil, but I like fractionated coconut oil. So that's, again, one more time, Siberian fir and lavender, 15 to 20 drops each, and then the rest is filled with fractionated coconut oil. So you can do in a 10 milliliter bottle, at least 20 to 25 drops, and then fractionated coconut oil. So those oils have been studied to help you go into theta brainwave mode. There's also a blend called Serenity, guaranteed, even though it may not have a research study on it, I guarantee you that one puts you in theta brainwave mode. So you can just put that on your pulse points on your neck and the back of your neck. So what you're gonna do is, this is what I started to do. So there, once I learned about the power of hypnosis and I went to hypnotherapy, it was interesting because some of the things that I worked on, so I'm gonna share my experience. He had me visualize as a child some of the traumatic experiences that I went through from being abused. And he had me, he guided me to see those with love for myself and even for the perpetrator, the person who was hurting me, and just had me, he just said, do you see that little 5-year-old girl? He's like, can you hug her right now? And so it's a lot of visualization, but you're in such a relaxed mode. You're not forcing it. Just, it's like it taps into, hypnotherapy taps into that theta brainwave mode, taps into those visualization centers. And I just was able to see that little 5-year-old girl, feel love for her instead of feeling like she was bad because, you know, she didn't swallow a pill well. I remember my stepdad did not like that I couldn't swallow pills, and so he would hurt me in order to make me swallow, and it wasn't good. But I was able to go to that moment and say, and just feel this love and compassion for this girl who was trying to please an authority figure by swallowing a pill, and even though having trouble and getting in trouble, that I wasn't bad. But I had filtered, I had created a belief that I was bad from that. And so, it actually took me a long time to be able to swallow pills. Now I can swallow pills just fine, but I had a little bit of traumatic experience with it. So that's one of them. But he had me do little situations like that. And what I noticed is, like, I don't know, this is the biggest thing, and it's kind of like vulnerable to tell you guys, but one of the biggest things I noticed was when I would get irritable, like out of weird situations, I didn't know what it was triggering from, and I just like, oh, it's irritating me. And I realized that I was feeling irritable because I was feeling like I was putting up a defense, like, I'm not doing something bad, I'm not doing something wrong, and I would get irritable. Anyway, the one thing I noticed about hypnotherapy, it took that away. That does not come up as a defense for me anymore. And that was just from the 3 sessions I went. And that was really cool to have that inner guard that I used to do to, because it was as a coping mechanism as a child. Like, I would get like, no, I'm not doing anything wrong, because I didn't want to get hurt. And that as an adult, even though logically I know like this person over here is not going to hurt me, but I would just automatically just get like, ugh, it's gone. And so what I recommend is I started doing, after this, I was like, how powerful just that belief system can change. Oh, thanks, Julie. Yeah. And what I recommend is doing this, because this is what I did afterwards, because I wasn't keep going to hypnotherapy because I was in another state that I went and saw this person. But I wrote out on a piece of, on like a notebook pad of paper, just as many pages as you want. And it took me about a month or two. And I would write out all the positive things that I would like to reprogram. And it took me a month or two because honestly, I was figuring out what those things were. I'd be triggered by something. I'm like, oh, okay, then I want the opposite. You know, if I was maybe triggered by someone saying, I'm trying to think of examples, but of maybe an unbelief in myself, I'd be like, nope, I'm capable of achieving anything I accomplish. And I just wrote down on a piece of paper about 3 pages worth of just positive things that I wanted, belief, like a stronger belief, maybe confidence. Maybe it is like I add value for people. Like, cause sometimes honestly I'll do talks and I'm like, oh, I don't know if it was really that helpful. And then I'm like, why would I think that? I add value for somebody. And so I would write that on my piece of paper. I add value. Somebody somewhere gets something out of what I am teaching. And so you can see I've heard these a lot, so I can just repeat them out of my head. But write down on a piece of paper 3 to 5 pages, just all these amazing positive things, whether you believe them or not, I don't care. Just write them down about yourself. Maybe if it's about nightmares or if it's about addictions or something like that, just say, I am free from anything that my body craves. Like, my body is free to crave healthy things. Or if it's nightmares, I sleep with peace. I have positive dreams. So what you want to make sure you steer clear of is saying the negative, like, I don't have nightmares. That's not going to help you. You've got to say, I have peaceful dreams that are just loving and I sleep wonderful. And so that's the type of things, if you want to work on nightmares plus whatever else, like, I am loved. I have so much value that I can share with other people. I'm just trying to think of all sorts of things. So what you're going to do is you're going to write those down, okay? After you're done writing those down, so that's going to be all in your beta brain, you know, so it's not in hypnotherapy brain. Thank you for writing those down. That's great. So you're going to, then you're going to take it and you're going to record yourself. I think it's very powerful to record your voice. Now, at first I was like, oh my gosh, am I going to feel weird listening to my voice? But I don't. And I don't know if it's just because I got over it, but it's so worth it to me to have these. I don't even care. So you're going to record on your phone, your voice recorder, and record yourself saying them. But what I recommend is using some type of meditation music. So I used one on YouTube from my hypnotherapy class. It's called Liquid X, and it's Liquid Mind X, I think is the name of it. So you can find that. But any type of just soft, something you'd go to sleep to. Basically, that's what you want. So not to Metallica, but so just something you'd go to sleep to. And you're going to record yourself saying these pages. I don't care how long. Mine's about 30 minutes long, 26 minutes. And you're just going to record yourself saying it to the music playing. Just go in a room, record it. Don't worry about how perfect it is. It's just a matter of saying the most positive and the outcomes that you want. So once you do that, every single night, this is what I do. I use my Theta Brain Blend and I put it on my pulse points. It's like right when I'm about ready to, you know, shut the lights out, I turn the lights off, I push play on my phone. My phone's on airplane mode, so don't think you have to have your phone on, but I push play on the voice memo, and then it turns off once the voice memo's done anyway, and I fall asleep to it. So every single night that I fall asleep to it, thank you for typing that in, Liquid Mind X on YouTube. Every night that I fall asleep to it, it's just going into my brain in theta brainwave mode. It's awesome. And here's what I recognize is that there are certain things that are in there that, how do you say it? Like that I feel like I'm good and I can move on and start focusing on other things. And so every few months I notice, like, I'm like, yeah, these are great. And I feel about 3 months, I would say, is where I'm like, I'm ready for some new ones. Let's dive even deeper. And so do something, do it for 90 days, 3+ pages, Maria, of whatever it is you really want to develop. And that's going to start changing like your entire belief system, because it's going to start strengthening those belief centers and those neural pathways and those neurotransmitters and those emotions so that your body will be more used to thinking and feeling that way. So I know I've gone a little over. This was a pretty big subject. So I know it's 10:30. Usually I do about 20 minutes. So I want to just end with a cool story that's, again, you can read my blog. I posted my research paper, but a really cool story from a guy named Chris that I was able to interview, and he shared his success story through hypnotherapy. He went to a Theta Wellness Center, which is in my blog. You can connect with them. And he had PTSD. He suffered great, you know, anxiety, nightmares, panic, trauma. He self-medicated with alcohol. And to the point, and his experience, you can actually hear more about it, his experience, but he was held at gunpoint, and there's more to it than that, but I'm just going to start there, and almost lost his life, watched somebody else have to die, and it just was a lot for him, and so had a lot of guilt and pain, so he started masking it with alcohol, to the point he almost killed himself, and he was rushed to the hospital and had his stomach pumped. He just could not get over the alcohol. And this was a year ago that the hospitalization happened. But he ended up after, you know, tons and tons of regular therapy treatment, and it didn't, you know, it helped a little bit, just didn't really get to that deeper level for him. He went to this hypnotherapy. And what happened was, from doing the 28-day program, he says now, he's like, he has no desire to drink alcohol. It's gone. He's like, I don't know what happened. He's like, but it's totally gone. Where before he would just crave it so bad. He said hypnotherapy did some wiring in his brain, and even if he smells alcohol, it makes him kind of sick to his stomach. So it's really cool. He's doing so great now and wants to share his story as a powerful, story of hope for those with PTSD and who have gone through trauma. So I know hypnotherapy can be amazing for you guys. The self-hypnosis is a great way to start. And yeah, let me know if you have any questions. Just go ahead and type them in there. And if not, we will see you guys next Tuesday for our Brain Talk Tuesday. So good to be connected with you all. And please let me know how your hypnotherapy soundtracks go. I want to hear how it's transforming you. It's amazing. So, all right, everybody. Thanks. Have a good day. Bye.